So there is nothing better than after a long day working on the farm with your animals than to jump into a nice, warm pool at the end of the day to relax. But it only really works if the water is warm most of the year, and that's why we have our Raypak pool heat pump. But I have to admit something. I made a few videos recently about pool heat pumps, and I really had no idea how they worked when we started a year ago with them. So I figured I wasn't the only one. Pool heat pumps are just like any air conditioner or heat pump in your house, and they work exactly the same way. It's all about refrigerant in the end. And thankfully, refrigerant has some very interesting and unique properties that heat pumps exploit to transfer heat. Refrigerant like this is used like water to absorb and release latent heat as it changes phases from a liquid to a gas and back to a liquid. What makes these refrigerants so useful is their flexible boiling points, and heat pumps take advantage of that fact and force it to happen through adjusting ambient pressures. For example, water boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit or 100 degrees Celsius, but that's as hot as it gets. Even if you keep water boiling and keep heating it, it's not going to get any hotter. But if you put water in a pressure cooker, it raises the pressure of that water and allows the water to be heated even more. Well, it's the same with the refrigerants used in these devices. So by changing the pressure of the refrigerant, we can raise and lower its boiling point and use that to transfer heat from the outside air into the pool water. Crystal clear? Well, let's break this down and take a look at an example of a heat pump to explain this further. Let's start with one of its main components, the compressor. The compressor is basically just a pump that compresses the refrigerant, but it's hermetically sealed so that way refrigerant can't leak out. Now, this might look familiar because a heat pump and an air conditioner work on the same principle as your home fridge. A compressor, in our case, is in the outside unit inside the coils, and it compresses a low-pressure refrigerant vapor into a liquid. Thanks to the increased pressure and the actual process of compressing, this liquid becomes very hot as it exits the compressor. And this is the hot stuff that then moves along the copper lines into the condenser. The condenser, in our case, looks something like a part of a moonshine still, or even part of a science experiment. It has an inner tube that's in our heat pump that carries that super hot liquid refrigerant out of the compressor, and then it's jacketed or surrounded by water from your pool. Now, as that water passes over that really hot tube, it heats up the water before exiting your heat pump and going back into your pool. At this point, though, is where the magic happens inside of your pool heat pump. At the end of the refrigerant line, after this condenser, is a small restrictive device called an expansion device. This can be a complicated device, or something as simple as a small diameter piece of tubing. This keeps the liquid in the condenser a pressurized hot liquid, but after it passes through this expansion device very slowly because it restricts the flow a lot, it causes the liquid to depressurize and turn into a liquid vapor fluid mix. Now, this fluid then moves into your main coils or your evaporator, or what you think you know as your air conditioner or heater. Now, you may have thought this was called an evaporator because of something it does to the heat or the outside air, but actually that's not the case. It's called an evaporator because it actually causes the refrigerant to evaporate inside the coils and then gain a small amount of heat in that coil, very small. This is assisted by the fan, which is in our case is in the center, which causes the airflow to go over these coils and into the evaporator. This helps to evaporate the refrigerant more effectively and efficiently. The part that's next in line helps to create a low pressure environment in the evaporator, which also in turn helps the liquid to vaporize and gain heat, the compressor. Then, as we know from before, the compressor will help to condense that warm vapor into a hot liquid for recirculation. That's pretty much it for the main guts of a pool heat pump. If you notice, this looks very similar to your household heat pump or air conditioner. They all have very similar pieces: an outdoor coil or a condenser, a compressor, which is typically inside the condenser, and copper lines. Then there's really only one difference: the condenser. As opposed to having the hot liquid circulate around water for your pool, it'll actually run inside your house, usually into your attic, and to another evaporator unit where air is passed through to be heated up. Now, I should also note, if you look more closely at most heat pumps, they're actually made by the same people that make residential heat pumps. I know, big surprise, right? Well, in our case, the Raypak pool heat pump that we have is actually made by Rheem, which is one of the major manufacturers of residential heating and cooling systems. Now, heat pumps are a generally new thing for pool heating and home heating in general too, really. The technology has existed for a long time, but it's just now becoming more and more popular. So you may be living in a dry climate like we do, and I've heard that heat pumps won't work well because of the low humidity. Well, that's not entirely accurate. The reason is actually pretty complicated, but the bottom line is that the more humidity that's in the air, the more heat you'll be able to transfer in the evaporator coils. That's not to say that if you're in a dry area, it won't work. Of course it will. It just may not be as efficient as it should be. And like I've mentioned in previous videos, we are in a very dry desert climate and have not only a pool heat pump, but also a residential heat pump that both work very well. So if you're thinking about getting a pool heat pump, don't let the big box stores tell you it won't work. I just wanted to take a quick moment and talk about the sponsor of today's video, and that is Audible. I've had Audible for years and still continue to use it to this day while I'm outside working on the farm or driving in the car. Now, they are the audiobook supplier, and you should consider trying them out. Right now, Audible has a special deal where if you follow the link below in the description and sign up for their monthly plan, you'll not only get your first month free, but included in that will be one free audiobook which you can keep for life, whether you keep their subscription or not. So my recommendation for today is a fun one, and that is 2001: A Space Odyssey. Now, I'm definitely no sci-fi nerd, but I do enjoy some sci-fi stories and movies occasionally, and this is the classic sci-fi story. So make sure to check out Audible in the link below in the description, because that helps out the channel a lot, and you get a free audiobook. So if you guys have any questions about pool heat pumps, how they work, or anything like that, feel free to drop them in the comments below. We've also gotten a ton of questions about how the heat pumps work, how they're installed, electrical stuff like that. Feel free to put any and all questions that you have in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Feel free to do that. Keep in mind, I'm not a licensed electrician or anything, but I've learned a little bit of how to deal with some of this stuff and work through some of these problems. So put it in the comments below if you have any questions, comments, anything at all, and I will get back to you. Thanks, guys, and make sure to join us next week as we continue our series on our garden boxes.